Hi students, today we are going to discuss about the properties of elements and properties of compounds. Now, the properties of elements, the first property of the elements are the type of pure substance. Why? Elements are called pure substance because an element is made up of only one kind of atom. The second property, it cannot be broken down into its further simpler forms by any means, either physical means or chemical means. That means an element is the simplest form of substance which exists in the nature and which cannot be further simplified by any means, either physical means or chemical means. That means the elements are the fundamental things with which all the matters of the universe are consist of. Third, elements may occur naturally because most of the element, that is 90% 90 number of elements exist in nature on its own, and the rest 30 elements which actually does not exist in the nature on its own, it exists in lab or places where conditions is provided. That means elements may occur naturally or may be prepared artificially in labs. The next property, the elements may be classified into four main categories on the basis of their natures, that metals, non-metals, metalloids and noble gases. Now, what are metals? The metals are the types of elements which have the tendency to produce their positive ions by losing one or more electrons. Non-metals are the types of elements which have the tendency to produce their negative ions by gaining one or more electrons. Metalloids are the group of elements which shows the some characters of metals and some characters of non-metals too. The fourth one, that is noble gases. Noble gases are kinds of non-metallic elements which are inactive in nature. That means they never takes part in chemical reaction. That means they already stable in nature, no need to take part in chemical reaction. So they are called noble gaseous elements or rare gaseous elements. The next, we have to discuss about the properties of the compounds. So just like elements, compounds are also a type of pure substance because it consists of a single types of molecules. The next property of the compounds, the compounds are homogeneous in matters because it consists of matters which have uniform composition throughout its body. Okay. The second characteristic features of the compounds, now it has fixed composition, that means definite compositions. Its compositions remains same irrespective of the places, time or conditions. Third one, the compounds is formed of elements, two or more than two kinds of elements when chemically combined in fixed proportions by their mass or volumes. Next property, the properties of the compounds are totally different from their constituent elements. For examples, a compound like carbon dioxide. Okay, carbon dioxide consists of two elements, carbon and oxygen. Carbon is a combustible substance, whereas oxygen is a supporter of combustion. But when carbon and oxygen chemically combines to give the molecules of carbon dioxide, its property gets changed, totally different from its constituent elements. It doesn't burn, neither burn nor support the combustion, rather it helps in the extinguishing of fire or combustible substances. Okay, the next properties of the compounds is compounds have a definite set of properties. Okay, that is all for the topic like properties of elements and properties of compounds. I hope you understand. And that is all for today. Thank you.